Want to replace your pencil soldering iron with something else? Today at the House of Hacks, we talk about one of your options for an inexpensive digital temperature controlled soldering station. Hi makers, builders, and do-it-yourselfers, Harley here. For years and years, I used a pencil type soldering iron. In fact, I started with one of these and I used one up until about 6 years ago. These are really inexpensive. They're usually less than $10 and they just plug right into an outlet. There's nothing in between. The cord goes directly into the soldering iron, and the resistance inside the soldering iron is what controls the temperature. They're not the best things around, but they get the job done. And like I said, I use these almost my whole life now. About 6 years ago, I picked up an inexpensive soldering station off of Amazon for about $60, and I've been really pleased with it. About 30 years ago, I used a Weller on the job briefly and really, really liked it. But it was a $300 soldering station. I'm guessing it was somewhere in that neighborhood. So significantly more expensive than what I was using. And for hobbyist use, it was more than I wanted to afford. But about 6 years ago, I picked up an inexpensive temperature controlled digital soldering station off of Amazon. And I've really enjoyed it. It works really well for hobbyist use around the workshop. And it's been my go-to iron for now the last 6 years or so. So let's take a look at some of the features that it has and just explore it a little bit. I have no idea how to pronounce this manufacturer. It's five vowels, but it's the 937 Plus and it's digitally controlled. It comes with this control unit, power cord, the soldering iron itself, a sponge for wiping the tip off, and a little holder to keep the hot soldering iron in and to hold the sponge. You can also put a roll of solder on here, and somewhere in my shop I have a little dowel thingy that holds the solder in here. But personally, I don't like putting the solder on there. It's a little bit cumbersome, and the rolls don't really fit on there very well. It's hard to get the solder out when you're trying to use it, so I just leave the solder loose. So one of the nice things about this unit is the tips on it are interchangeable. They have a number of different designs for different types of applications. And the way you change it is you just loosen this little knurl and this heat shield comes off and the tip just slides on. And there inside we can see the ceramic element that is the heating element. And you can get all kinds of different tips for this. This one is a small sharp tip that works really well for general electronics use. It's large enough to work for most applications, but small enough that you can get in on PCBs and stuff. They also have things like chisel and angled tips and a number of different styles, depending on your application. You have the power switch on the front that turns it on, and you have a digital display that shows the current temperature. So it kind of has two modes depending on what it's doing. Normally it shows the current temperature, but if you press the up and down buttons, it shows the temperature that you're setting it to. And when you let go after a couple seconds, it reverts back to the current temperature of the soldering iron. It takes 30 to 60 seconds to initially come up to temperature. Once it's at temperature, it holds the temperature really well. And I've not had a problem with it dropping temperature. It always keeps it right spot on what you set it for. It'll go all the way up to 480. This is Celsius. So that's 800 and something, almost 900 degrees Fahrenheit. And it goes down to 200, I believe, is the lowest it'll go. So you can set it in 1 degree Celsius increments anywhere between those two ranges. One thing I don't like about it is this base. It's pretty lightweight and moves around pretty easily. And also the soldering iron is kind of touchy in terms of how it fits in there. It's easy for it to not get in there quite right. And so I'm not a big fan of this little base thing. I use it sometimes. A lot of times I'm using this Panavice for my projects, and it has its own soldering iron holder in it. If I'm using this, I just use that instead. It's a whole lot more convenient. Works really well. So it's a real basic, simple unit. It gets the job done really well. Like I said, it's about $60. I'll leave a link to it down in the description below if you're interested in this particular model. Check out Amazon for this and other competitors. If you're a subscriber here at House of Hacks, I want to thank you for joining me on a regular basis on this continuing creative journey that we're on. And if you're new to House of Hacks, I believe everyone has a God-given creative spark that sometimes manifests through making things with a mechanical or technical bent to them. And I hope to inspire, educate, and encourage these types of makers in their woodworking, metalworking, electronics, photography, and other similar endeavors. If this sounds interesting to you, go ahead and subscribe, and I'll see you again in the next video. Thanks again for joining me on this creative journey we're on, and until next time, go make something. Perfection's not required, fun is.